Hello, fellow traders. In this video, I'll introduce you to a practical and effective scalping strategy for NinjaTrader 8, Fleet Barracuda Scalping. This strategy is designed to simplify your scalping approach while enhancing your profitability. With a follow-the-trend philosophy, Fleet Barracuda Scalping offers a clear and easy-to-follow method, regardless of your trading experience. Plus, we'll explore a straightforward stop-loss placement to safeguard your capital. So, if you're seeking a no-nonsense approach to improve your scalping, stay tuned. I'm here to walk you through the Fleet Barracuda scalping strategy and how you can benefit from it. Let's dive in. The scalping strategy includes fiber scalping, solar wind RK, and a renko bar we can't do without, King Renko. So, why King Renko? It's pretty simple. Fiber scalping operates in a unique way, leaning on Fibonacci retracement levels. And to make that work effectively, we rely on Renko bars that show real OHLC data. Let's take a look at the parameters of each indicator. Solar Wind RK is quite versatile, offering different signal types. But for this scalping strategy, we're keeping it simple. We're only using the trend signal type. You've got two ways to spot the market trend with Solar Wind RK: trend signals and trailing stop plots. Here is a downtrend signal, and the pink trailing stop here is also a cue for a downtrend. We've got a trend signal right here, along with a blue trailing stop that's a sign of an uptrend. Now, I'm going to show you the rule to find entry points in the Fleet Barracuda scalping strategy for NinjaTrader 8. The area between the trend vector and trailing stop of Solar Wind RK gives you a zone to filter entry signals from fibar scalping. We choose a fibar scalping signal when it aligns with the trend direction indicated by Solar Wind RK, and the preceding reversal bars open or close price falls within the zone defined by Solar Wind RK's trend vector and trailing stop. One convenient aspect of this scalping strategy for NinjaTrader 8 is its optimal stop placement. We position the stop just above or below selected signals, precisely on the trailing stop plot of Solar Wind RK. In this instance, both fiber scalping signals make the cut since the open prices of the preceding reversal bars are inside the zone. We're ignoring this signal because it's in opposition to the current trend. This signal doesn't meet the criteria since both the open and close prices of the reversal bar that came before it are located outside the zone marked by Solar Wind RK's trend vector and trailing stop. The signal here is eliminated because it goes against the trend direction. Solar Wind RK's trend signals have alerted us to the market's shift into a bullish state. This fibar scalping signal is chosen because it's in sync with the uptrend, and the open price of the previous reversal bar falls within the signal selection zone. Applying the criteria I've discussed, you'll see that this buy signal checks all the boxes. This sell signal is disregarded as it conflicts with the uptrend indicated by Solar Wind RK. Although the sell signal here matches the bearish trend, we're bypassing it due to the open and close prices of the preceding reversal bar lying beyond the zone set by Solar Wind RK's trend vector and trailing stop. We're going with this sell signal here because it's in harmony with the downward trend, and the open price of the preceding reversal bar falls within the zone marked by Solar Wind RK's trend vector and trailing stop. We also select this fibar scalping signal as the prior reversal candle has the open price within the area between the trend vector and trailing stop of Solar Wind RK. Due to its conflict with the trend direction signaled by Solar Wind RK, we're not considering this buy signal. We will dismiss these two sell signals because they run counter to the upward trend indicated by Solar Wind RK. The market has entered a bullish phase. The upward trend signal and the blue trailing stop let us know the market has turned bullish. Because the open price of the reversal bar here falls within the signal selection zone, the adjacent 5-bar scalping signal is qualified. Solar Wind RK helped us filter out a false sell signal from 5-bar scalping, as it conflicted with the ongoing upward trend. This signal here is selected because the open price of the previous reversal bar falls within the zone set by the trend vector and trailing stop of Solar Wind RK. Similarly, we will choose this buy signal generated by 5-bar scalping. Observing the trend signal and the pink trailing stop of Solar Wind RK, we know that the market is under a downward condition. Since both the open and closed prices of the reversal bar fall within the signal selection zone, we will choose this signal. Now that you're familiar with the rules, it's time for you to put it into action and filter out the entry signals from 5-bar scalping. Let's check if you've got it right. Let's briefly review all the signals we've just analyzed. We intentionally selected a lengthy, continuous market phase to analyze fleet Barracuda scalping signals. This demonstrates our objective analysis and proves the NinjaTrader 8 scalping strategy's reliability in filtering out false signals. The Fleet Barracuda scalping strategy goes beyond being a tool, it's a trading mindset. It equips you with trends, zones, signals, and clear rules to confidently navigate the fast-paced world of scalping. May your trading endeavors be as swift and successful as the Barracuda in the deep blue sea. Thank you for watching our video and exploring the Fleet Barracuda scalping strategy for NinjaTrader 8. To stay up to date with our latest content, be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. Until next time, happy trading!